Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us. I'm Brad Smith, the president of Microsoft. I'm joined here today with Peter Lee, who heads Microsoft's healthcare business, and John Cahan, who leads our new AI for Health program. We want to share in the next few minutes some work that has been months in the making. Months in the making, all that lead up to today's announcement. We're today introducing our newest AI for Good program, AI for Health. For those of you who have been following our work in this space around artificial intelligence and our AI for Good effort, this is our newest addition to a suite of programs, our AI for Good programs. A lot of people perhaps first got to know Microsoft through our software suites. Microsoft Office is perhaps the most popular and widely used software suite in the world today. Well, in a sense, we've taken everything that we've learned from the world of software and brought it to the issues around artificial intelligence and what it can do for the world. We created our AI for Good effort to address the world's biggest challenges. We're all familiar with the problems of our era, some big, some small, some impact everyone on the planet, some simultaneously, some have a huge impact on members of our family. One of the things we've learned is that artificial intelligence can be one of the world's greatest tools for good. But it requires that we approach this with the ability to work with others, build on what AI has to offer, and really address the problems at hand. That's what we've worked to do with all of our AI for Good programs. We've sought to take a consistent and strategic approach. We first started on this journey a bit more than 2.5 years ago when we launched our first program, AI for Earth. It's a $50 million five-year effort focused on four big sustainability issues and needs, issues around climate, agriculture, biodiversity, and water. We talked about our sustainability goals just 2 weeks ago here in Redmond, Washington, and we'll be continuing to expand our work in AI for Earth, in part building on this effort. We followed AI for Earth with our second effort, AI for Accessibility. This focuses on the needs of the billion people on this planet that have some kind of disability, permanent or temporary. And like AI for Earth, it also focuses on very concrete opportunities to make a difference in people's lives. That's why we focus on issues like employment and whether people can get a job and whether technology can help, whether AI can make a difference in people's daily lives or people's abilities to communicate and connect with others. Already, just as we found in AI for Earth, we're finding in AI for Accessibility and this $25 million five-year initiative that it's all about the partners that we work with. Like the partner who creates Inner Voice, an app that helps people with learning disabilities learn how to interact, learn how to read, learn how to communicate. Building on the success of these first two, we launched at the UN General Assembly program just 1.5 years ago our third initiative, AI for Humanitarian Action. Here too, we've been working on concrete problems, often to support agencies of the United Nations or the world's great nonprofits, large and small, that are responding to disasters around the world, that are working with refugees and displaced people, that are protecting human rights or really addressing the needs of children. Based on the progress with this effort, we followed it last summer with AI for Cultural Heritage, our fourth effort. This focuses on the heritage that is fundamental to communities around the world, the preservation of the stories of people, the places in which they've lived, in some cases, the places that literally define the culture of different communities, the languages people speak, and the artifacts that are important. Building on all four of these, we're excited because today is all about another step forward, our fifth program, AI for Health. This is a $40 million five-year commitment that now brings our suite of programs to $165 million. But more than the money we spend, Frankly, even more than the technology we will use, as important as it is our focus on working with experts to address the world's great challenges. In this case, the world's health challenges and opportunities. So as you'll hear today, we're launching this initiative to focus on the quest of discovery, the search for the cures of the diseases that plague humanity. We're focused on understanding better, using AI, the insights about global health, insights that can enable medical professionals around the world to be more effective in what they do. And we're focused on health equity. We all readily appreciate that of the 7.8 billion people on this planet, every day, some have access to better health care than others. These are three great health challenges that literally affect the world. And as you'll hear, these are three challenges where artificial intelligence and AI for health can make a difference. Take a look at this short video, and then I'll turn it over to Peter.
It's the symbiotic relationship between the human and machine that brings the magic of AI to medicine in a meaningful way.
Now we have the tools to make a huge difference to human life.
Cancer research is increasingly powered by data. Those data remain siloed across institutions.
We're creating a data ecosystem that allows people to share data and making sure that we're doing that in a way that still maintains the privacy of the patients.
With the power of AI, we can go after the unknown. And I can guarantee that we'll find something that nobody expected.
Sudden infant death syndrome scares every mother and father, and it is a problem. We have to change. The collaboration with Microsoft, AI for Health, will help to start this next step of our discovery. Our data show very convincingly clear correlation between smoking and SIDS, and just changing behavior can save children's lives. You cannot measure the benefit of that.
It's a sad day when the patient comes in and I can't impact them.
Through AI for Health, we will be building an AI solution that can autonomously diagnose diabetic retinopathy.
With the portable camera, I can take healthcare to the patients who would not be able to come to us.
I want you to look right here.
Going forward, we can address the 500 million patients that are out there and disrupt this disease. AI for Health and Iris together can have that impact.
Today, there are 200,000 leprosy patients diagnosed every year. If you catch it in the stage of a skin lesion, you can cure the person. We are teaching an AI algorithm to recognize leprosy in an image of a skin lesion.
With AI, we can help patients help themselves to get to the right experts at the right time. If you can help a child to not lose their fingers, that means everything.
Innovation comes from bringing different perspectives together. And what an amazing partnership this is for all of us.
When you see that you can make a big impact on somebody's life, that's the greatest thing ever.
We can help eliminate the oldest disease known to man and make history. That's how we want to contribute to the world.
Thank you, Brad. And thank you to everyone joining us in person and watching online. We're truly fortunate to have such great company for this announcement today. In our quest to bring the cloud and AI to as many people as possible, to empower people and organizations on the planet to achieve more, we've developed a tremendous ambition to apply these technologies to healthcare. I'm Peter Lee, and I have the privilege of leading Microsoft's research and development activities in the healthcare and life sciences. And I'm thrilled today to be part of this announcement to launch AI for Good, led by John Cahan and his team. Today, when we bring AI to people, we do it in partnership. And many of you watching today have already been partnering with us in deep collaboration to bring some of our best ideas together, your knowledge, your problems, your insights, along with our technologies and our AI, merging these together in an integrated way to address some of the most urgent applications in healthcare and life sciences around the world. When we work together in this way, in partnership, oftentimes what we find is that it all comes down ultimately to data. Data is the fuel that brings us new AI technologies, new insights, and new knowledge. In Microsoft, we work today with over 168,000 healthcare organizations around the world, but the leading organizations that we interact with constantly are bringing us new opportunities based on data that they have collected and that they are generating every day. And working with them, we can actually identify the actual health data and expose that to machine learning technologies and put that in the hands of innovators, and ideally bringing these to scalable healthcare innovations. But there's a problem, and it's a problem that we sometimes refer to as the health data funnel. That as we work through that whole process, we find increasing difficulties in actually bringing that data to life. Working in partnership and also addressing some of the key issues in data interoperability, in compliance, in data privacy and security, we are finding we are making dramatic progress in partnership. I'd like to give two examples just to give you a hint at what's possible. Working with a great Seattle biotech company, Adaptive Biotechnologies, we've been engaged in the study of the adaptive immune system. When your doctor takes a sample of your blood, she holds in her hands a sample of the T cells. Those T cells, each one being genetically programmed to attack a specific antigen, a carrier of disease. When Adaptive Biotechnologies takes that sample, they have a proprietary sequencing technology that gives a printout of a specific bit of DNA, a specific protein in the extracellular receptor of those T cells, the T cell receptor. And so now the question is, can we use AI to look at that printout and discern, translate that into the language of disease to understand exactly what cancers, what infectious diseases, and what autoimmune disorders your body is coping with right at this moment? Working with Adaptive Biotechnologies, we've been able to generate the data sets needed in order to fuel and build machine learned models. And we are very rapidly zeroing in on a new generation of early diagnostic tools that may have the ability to transform early diagnosis of cancer and infectious diseases. In a second example, today, when we look at cancer treatment, there is tremendous amount of data that comes in the form of new research insights. In fact, every day, there are thousands of new research abstracts and research papers published in the area of clinical oncology. And putting those thousands of new research advances every day up against the 1.7 million new cancer cases per year leads us to a tremendous curation problem. How can we ensure that a molecular tumor board that is trying to make the match between a specific genetic shape of a particular patient's cancer is benefiting from the knowledge of that torrent of research publication. Working together, we're able to develop new AI-powered machine reading capabilities that augment what a human tumor board is able to do and benefit from the latest published research, leaving no fact behind. And with this, we're hoping that we can superpower cancer treatment in the future using AI and data. So, with just those two examples, I hope you can see that there's tremendous opportunity here. We just cannot imagine what the possibilities are, but by working in partnership, bringing data, AI, and really depth of insight and knowledge in health and life sciences, we think that there is the possibility of working towards a better future for human health. And so for that, I'm just tremendously excited to see John Cahan and his team launch this new program in AI for Health. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Peter. I'm delighted and honored to run the AI for Health initiative as part of my mission to infuse AI and data to help solve some of the world's great challenges. As our president, Brad Smith, laid out, AI for Health has three key areas of focus. And today, I'm going to let our partners speak about each of the areas and the kind of work that they're doing in quest for discovery, in global health insights, and health equity. I'll start with a relationship with Seattle Children's Research Institute in the area of sudden infant death syndrome. You may not realize, but SIDS is the leading cause of death for infants 1 month to 1 year old in the United States and all developed countries in the world. I saw firsthand, both personally and professionally, how you can marry artificial intelligence and medical research to advance this field firsthand. I saw because I lost my first son and only son to SIDS, and I saw our head of data science partner with leading medical experts at Seattle Children's and research institutes all over the world. Today, based on their work, they can now estimate that 22% of the deaths from SIDS are a direct result of attributed to smoking. They also can do, through statistics now, understanding that SIDS, as people thought, is likely more than one thing, as deaths occurring during that first week of life are likely different than children that die later on. So let's listen to our partners at Seattle Children's and the groundbreaking work that they're doing powered by artificial intelligence.
No parent expects to lose their child, especially not during the first year of life. Sudden infant death syndrome is a huge problem that we have to change. My task is to combine scientists, geneticists, patient data to solve some of these mysteries of neurological disorders. Our data show very convincingly clear correlation between smoking and SIDS. We have already started whole genome sequencing, and this AI for Health grant will help in the analysis to start this next step of our discovery. We're now using genetic information to explain why a particular child has died, giving closure to the parents and using this information to prevent further loss. The next step is to use all this information to recognize a child that is at risk. By understanding the genetic underpinnings leading to the sudden infant death syndrome, we'll not only solve problems of infant mortality, we'll understand a lot of the problems that we have with infants. I mean, that's a gift that is unbelievable to express.
In this second area, with our partnership with the Novartis Foundation, we are blessed to take on one of the world's oldest infectious diseases with artificial intelligence and experts around the world called leprosy. You may not realize, but 7 million people in the last 10 years have been diagnosed with leprosy. There are 200,000 cases every year in this space, and over 3 million people are estimated to be undiagnosed in this space. This creates tremendous physical deformities and negative social stigma. But AI can and will make a difference in this space. Let's listen to Dr. Ann Arts and the work that Novartis Foundation is doing with a world-class data scientist from Microsoft to change this for the millions of people around the world.
Today, there are over 200,000 patients with leprosy diagnosed every year. Leprosy comes with an enormous stigma. People lose their jobs, lose their families, and are very afraid to seek healthcare in time. If you catch it in the stage of a skin lesion, you can cure the person. The partnership with Microsoft AI for Health will help us to accelerate diagnosis of leprosy. We are teaching an AI algorithm to recognize leprosy in an image of a skin lesion. We hope that this digital solution will help us also map where hotspots are.
If you have AI embedded in the phone, it can actually detect and mark the region and automatically say the potential for being a leprosy condition so we can help patients to get to the right experts at the right time. It's the symbiotic relationship between the human and machine that actually brings the magic of AI to medicine in a meaningful way. If you can help a child to be healthy and happy, that means everything. And that's why we do what we do.
In this third example in the area of health equity, we talk about an area with our partnership with IRIS. A small area in what people may know, but the reality is this is where AI can make a difference. There are over 460 million people in the world that are at risk of going blind with diabetic retinopathy. It is the leading cause of preventable blindness globally. However, there are only 210,000 ophthalmologists. This is simply not possible to scale with humans alone. This is where AI not only can make a difference, but is making a difference. We already have AI models in the lab that are closing the gap with up to 97% accuracy, on par with ophthalmologists. We certainly have a ways to go on this journey, but our goal is to bridge the gap and help those in underserved communities. Let's listen to Dr. Sunil Gupta at IRIS and the tremendous work that they're doing in the field with our world-class data scientists and artificial intelligence.
Diabetic retinopathy is a leading cause of blindness all over the world. 95% of it is preventable.
Every person with diabetes needs an annual eye exam, but only 35% get them. We need to make it more accessible.
The opportunity for IRIS is to take technology to underserved communities. We can train an individual to be able to utilize these specialized tools.
With the portable camera, I can take healthcare to the patients who would not generally be able to come to us.
We've detected 73,000 patients with sight-threatening diseases.
Through AI for Health, we will be building an AI technology solution that can autonomously diagnose diabetic retinopathy.
AI allows us to identify very detailed pathology that the human eye may not be able to pick up. It also will help us identify patients that are at the highest risk of heart disease, risk of stroke, risk of Alzheimer's.
Our partnership will allow us to reach more patients across the country, across the world.
When you see that you can make a big impact on somebody's life, that's the greatest thing ever.
In this last example, we're attacking one of the biggest challenges that we have in health, the balance between privacy and innovation. This is critical for us to succeed. Clearly, privacy and security of personal data is at the forefront of everything that we do in health. We need to deliver new advanced capabilities to unlock the data, to unlock the possibilities, to combine data, to allow people to work in ways they've never done before. Let's listen to the partnership that we've created with Fred Hutch and the other partners at the Cascadia Data Discovery Initiative and the work that we're doing with our data scientists to do this across the Cascadia corridor on this part of the United States and worldwide.
Researchers want to see their work make an impact.
Cancer research is increasingly powered by data. Those data remain siloed across institutions.
There's a lot of value that's waiting to be unlocked. We need to break down these walls.
With Microsoft AI for Health, we're creating a data ecosystem that allows people to share data.
We're building a framework to comply with regulations whereby people can advertise data to each other.
Health research data is obviously very personal and very private. Differential privacy can help to protect patient privacy while also allowing us to do the research.
Where we can leverage artificial intelligence, we can move things forward 1,000-fold, 10,000-fold. we're going to see it change all aspects of healthcare, even how patients themselves engage in the research process.
The biggest thing we can go after is the unknown. And with the amount of data that we'll get, I can guarantee that we'll find something that nobody expected.
Well, today is just a step along the way, and a lot of ways, it is just the beginning. It's just the beginning to empower researchers and organizations with AI to advance the health of people and communities in the world. Health is a critical issue. It transcends borders, it transcends populations, and it is critical to the survival of our species on this planet. We have seen already where AI can make a difference. With our partners around the world who are experts, we will go to places where people can't or won't, and we will make a difference. And we'll do that with world-class partners and partnerships in every part of the three pillars that we outlined today. Thank you very much. We appreciate all your support in the days and weeks ahead.